So is the House Speaker reacting to the new revelations, or does she know that it's a losing battle for Democrats? We're asking Texas Congressman Lance Gooden. Thank you so much for joining us this morning. We appreciate it.
Thank you. Thanks for having me.
So as we begin our discussion, let's take a look at some of those key complaints or key issues made in this whistleblower complaint. Amongst them, White House officials acted to lock down records of the call. May not have been the first time that the White House actually tried to conceal some transcripts, and that there was some official and unofficial follow-up to President Trump's call. Ukrainian officials may have understood that they needed to go along with the president in order to have this phone call to begin with. So what is your take on all of this as it stands now, the transcript of the call along with the whistleblower complaint?
Well, first of all, the transcript has absolutely nothing impeachable in it. Whether you like it or not, it's just not an impeachable offense. We're looking for high crimes and misdemeanors, and we haven't found them. Yet the Democrats are still moving forward with this. As respects the whistleblower complaint, when I read that, it looks like a political agenda. It looks like something written by the New York Times or definitely an attorney. It's not pure factual reporting. It's laced with opinion. I think it's very concerning.
What about Nancy Pelosi herself? She seems to be going back and forth on this impeachment issue. What do you think about her latest comments? Why do you think, or do you think, she's kind of maybe backtracking a little bit?
Well, the worst thing that could happen for the Democrats is for this to move too quickly, because what they really don't want to happen is for them to impeach the president and this be over. They want to drag this out throughout 2020, all the way into the election, because they know they're not going to get the votes they want in the Senate to actually throw the president out of office. They want this to carry on and carry on and carry on. And furthermore, they don't want to actually take a vote. That's the whole reason that we're criticizing Jerry Nadler as chairman of his committee, because he's moving forward with an investigation that hasn't been authorized by the U.S. House. They know they don't have the votes to pass it. They're also trying to protect those 31 Democrats that are in House districts that President Trump won in 2016. Mm-hmm. They know that the American people don't support impeachment, and those 31 incumbent Democrats will suffer if they actually have to go on record.
And since you brought this up, let's move to that. You've introduced this legislation to oust Nadler from the judiciary chair spot over the impeachment proceedings. Mm-hmm. Let's take a look at some of that resolution as you describe it to us and tell us why.
Yes, so Chairman Jerry Nadler has said multiple times since his hearings have begun earlier this past summer that he is undertaking an impeachment. He is impeaching the president. These are his words. They're not mine. That's just not been authorized by the House. Speaker Pelosi, what she said this week about, "I am officially opening an inquiry," she can't do that. She's just saying that. And what she said changes absolutely nothing that's been happening these past few months. The speaker, all she's done this week is say she herself is fully on board. If you go back over the last 25 years, the U.S. House has impeached three officials, William Jefferson Clinton and two federal judges. In all three cases, a vote was taken by the U.S. House to take up impeachment. If you go back to the Clinton days, Jerry Nadler delivers a lovely speech saying that the full House should be voting on this, mm-hmm. and that there should be bipartisan support. He criticizes the process. Fast forward to now, they won't even take up a vote for a few reasons. One, they don't have the votes. Two, they don't want to get their vulnerable Democrat incumbents on record.
Yeah, I mean, and we use this phrase a lot, but just basically throwing out red meat to their constituents because they know that that's what they want to hear, but then they know at the same time these aren't the legal steps and processes that they need to take.
That's right. And I've heard this week so many times from my sanctimonious Democratic friends across the aisle. They've said, "We can't have anyone that's above the law. We'll follow the law. Let's take this thing up for a vote." To quote a senator I heard earlier this week, "Grow a spine or go on Amazon and buy one if you want to impeach the president. Let's put it on the House floor and let's vote on it."
Hey, well, they say you can buy anything on Amazon, so I'll do a search for that.
Thank you so much,
Congressman Gooden.
Thanks.
We appreciate it. Have a great weekend.
Thank you.
Well, now to a Fox News alert for you, though. This is very...